March, I did it. Got the cup, I achieved what I set out to achieve. It took Gary 162 hours to paint the bike, which was quite remarkable that, he sort of didn't get bored doing it, but he certainly didn't. He took great pride, in what he did and was phoning me up every other day saying, how should we do this, how should we do that? And, because he was obviously concerned about budget, because 162 hours is not cheap. But once you saw the bike taking shape, you couldn't not do the next stage. It was crazy to say, this has cost a fortune so far and stop. You just had to finish it off. Airbrushing is, in my opinion, every bit as good as an artist working with a hand brush, because he's working with a gun, with paint coming out of, and really and truly, to me, that's harder than using a paintbrush. I would have loved to have gone to the Isle of Wight this year, but things didn't work out.
Motorcycle Action Group play a major part in letting people like us build these type of bikes, purely because government legislation would really rather we didn't build our own style of bikes, didn't lead the sort of lifestyle we do. To be honest, to ride something like this and to have it not legal is asking for trouble. They may look like piles of poo, but they're legal piles of poo.
Make sure they're legal. Basically we've been building them for years now. So you have to get them MOT'd every year, obviously. So you build it up, you take it for an MOT. If it doesn't pass an MOT, you know it's not legal for the road. You take it home, fix it, take it back in, passes, it passes.
Basically, this weekend's on August Bank Holiday, the Isle of Wight Scooter Rally. It's one of the biggest rallies of the year, and we decided we were going to come. For various reasons, and things ain't always going to plan. I'm really mightily pissed off, actually. The Isle of Wight's like 8 miles away, and it's taken us like 2 weeks to get this far, and I just want to go. Thank you.
Still haven't
beat
my record for 8 hours yet.
But it's the weekend. I don't want to beat it. I can get back up with them freezes.
Fucking boat.
Basically, the gear selector arm's snapped, which means that Mr. Miller here can't select gear. Not a problem if you carry the spares with you.
Hey. There's a big lump of black cheese at the back in here.
Oh, sorry, just show you know my engines.
Oh, is it? Scottish shit. It's all right. Yeah, it smells of tart.
Pitch.
Generally, we only get problems if we have a big group of people riding down for anything special.
On Vespers?
Well, it's not been major. I mean, like, mind you, we've still got 8 miles to go, so anything can happen in the next half hour.
Bacardi. Lime. Soda. Regal. All-round independent suspension gives the Mondeo a much smoother, quieter ride. For those who like that sort of thing. One more reason why 2.2 million families trust Mondeo.
Nivea Soft. It's sensational. Bringing softness to my skin instantly. It's incredible. So light and quickly absorbed. It's like gentle summer rain on my skin. Sensational Nivea Soft. The soft sensation for beautiful skin.
Look, this is what Mum is made of. It's a little sailing boat. Put in your lunchbox. Oh, wow. Well, it's a fireman's helmet. And, got a little igloo. Now, want Mummy to make you a set of funny ears? What's it?
McVitie's mini Jaffa cakes, deliciously self-centered.
This woman is about to save someone's life. Yesterday, she gave blood. Do something amazing today. Call 0345 711 711. Please.
We know that buying an ISA will never be the most exciting thing in your life. So the least B2 can do is make the whole process painless.
Visit b2.com or call 0800 626262 for an ISA information pack.
Phoenix, new from Lynx.
I just want to.
It's been a long day.
It has been a very long day already.
You want some funny money?
Ah, it's a good buzz today. Freaked out some straights. It's got to be done. Yeah? The media stereotype with scooters is that everybody is a mod. You know, it's apart from the 60s.
We had mods, we had scooters, we were on the road.
Yeah. The island is now ours.
The island is ours. This weekend, we're going to take over the island. The island will be, by Monday, a nice shade of matte black, hopefully.
It'll be Isle of Black.
Isle of Black, yeah. Yeah. Look at there's fucking loads of ripe machines out there ready to cut down.
Yeah.
Loads of them.
And I only brought a junior hacksaw.
But it's nice to be here. No, you ain't got to get back and, well, you haven't got to move for another couple of days, you know what I mean? Except to wander around finding beer and that, so, you know, it's cool. Yeah, Ivan and Baz, or Graham as his real name is, and Baz have come down from Scotland. Miller's come down from Rutland, so's Harold and Nob and That's nice. I mean, they broke the journey by coming down last night, but still a long way to come for a crack, isn't it?
When it come off?
I can't get the lid off of
it. Sounds technical.
Yeah. More bread?
Yeah, we'll have a little bit of bread. Just let me throw up my eyes. That'll do.
Margarine as well.
No, we'll just have it neat. Have the bread. Break me a bit off. That's better.
They're all sausages to get on with. Or we'll make them meat.
No, it's alright, I'll eat my bread.
Home cooking, this is. Home cooking. To Les and Janet, that's Les, that's Janet. They live down in Hayward's Heath.
Might not come. We're not sure what do's we're going to go to at night, but it's definitely a ride out because that's the main thing really. It's the best thing to go out on, really, a ride out.
It's 11:20. What did they do?
It's all right.
Yeah, it's not bad. Right. Yeah, it's
bad
a good
a bit
night.
Of a boogie, ain't we?
Yeah. We've been up fucking dancing.
Tears
shit
smiles.
Hot. That's what it's all about. Ride 400 miles to fucking get pissed, have a dance.
There's no really deep about it all. You just come here for a piss up, really.
That's
some people are a bit keen on it, but at the end of the day, it's just one big piss up, I hope.
You can hear the music to dance with without all the 150 decibels going into your ear. Because I think in this day and age, it's technically possible to have a silent disco. What if everyone would have a little sort of radio in with headphones. So you go into a disco and there's no noise, but you see all these people jigging about on the floor. You know, in this day and age, it is technically possible to do that.
That would look something, wouldn't it? With the brace pressure, would you? I mean, the bass drum pushing your chest in and out, saving your heart from working.
Yeah. Steve.
What?
Seems to be having trouble getting it fixed. Is that right?
Lots of trouble trying to get it fixed. It's a pile of shit. I'm going to go out and buy a fucking Honda Melody next week. Now I've lost the fucking spark plug.
What, that one there?
No, not that one, the other one.
Oh!
Yeah, it's a Lambretta. It's more luck than fucking judgment.
Day 5. Things ain't gone to plan.
Look, I'm trying not to be in a very good mood. Fuck off.
Ooh. That's the piston hole.
Custom shows aren't real life. Custom shows aren't bikes people use to work every day and back and then drive 500 miles at the weekend. That's what a lot of this scooter is about. The people that use their bikes day in, day out, no matter what the weather, they're the people, as far as I'm concerned, the real scooters. And one year everybody's in the street races, next year everybody's in the chops, then somebody's in the restoring them. They get to the end of that and then they start all over again. Piece of piss to go to a shop and say, here's a blank check, build me a show winner. A lot of people do that.
Cheers, thanks a lot.
We don't build them to get a £5 piece of plastic that somebody laughingly calls a trophy. You know, that's not what it's about for us. Half a dozen people taking a photograph's worth more than any piece of crap any bloody custom show judge can give you. It's rubbish. Custom shows are crap.
Custom paint job today, look, on that. 5 minutes. Custom paint job, you see. Gone from green to black. Looks much better.
And one easy lesson.
It used to be black.
She's even still got.
Yes.
plastic coat as well.
Yeah, that's it. I don't buy rubbish.
Oh, yeah. I'm a bit of Halfords man myself.
Mind you, I put too much petrol in the tank earlier and it all
come out
bubbled up. All the paint did.
Not to worry.
Made it look better. It looks better, matte black. Yeah. It highlights it, doesn't it?
Yeah.
The matte black hides all the rust. Which, you know, I've been growing that rust for a long time. I've left it out. I've left it out in the rain for a couple of years and it was coming on good.
He's my mate and I love him, he's loved him.
How many other people do you know that sell you an engine that blows up within?
Nah.
Alex, how far was it?
What's that?
How far did we get today?
The other day, you mean?
You slept? Oh, yeah. About that far, wasn't it?
Yeah. It went backwards.
Put the plug back in, mate.
Not further than this. It's not going to let me fucking forget that I sold him a VW engine, is it? I don't fucking know.
Put it in the
trike
and it fucked up.
Oh, you joking.
Got a puncher fixed, no tire on the bike. And I'm moseying on down to Heathrow. I'll get his phone call. Oh, them jobs that got all day. Where the geezer can see people getting on his plane.
Oh, aren't you used to this kind of thing?
I know.
Yeah.
Not
so often.
Especially a bit gutty after a while.
Yeah,
what did I fucking say to you? I said, is it fucking
Spartan just now? I want it, Paul.
No.
Have you got a P2 here? Coil?
Yeah.
Oh, can we try that? Just to try it.
Just try it.
Yeah?
Good.
Only if it's under your seat.
It's under the seat, yeah.
I didn't mean taking off your bonnet.
Come here to the Isle of Wight, meet everybody. Doesn't matter if you've got chops or cut downs, street racers, mod scooters, we'll all get along great. Have a good time, have a few drinks, have a laugh. It's just brilliant, it's such a great atmosphere to be in. Well, basically, it's a 1969 Lambretta GP125DL. I've always enjoyed it. I've caught with my girlfriend on it, so it's a bit sentimental to me.
What is it you like the best about being here?
The dudes. The nightlife.
The sex.
Nothing to do with 60s mod at all. This is pure early 70s skinhead. So, that's definitely the day I'm going for. I'm pleased with the look of it. It's a bit too slow, so I'll have to I'll get a faster engine sorted out for next year.
The fallings out when we first got together because
tell them that story.
He used to have a nice shiny black Vespa P200 and it had front carrier and
mirrors,
lights and
over.
Mirrors and stuff
whip
like
aerials.
That. Oh, whip aerial and I am the face in pinstripe down one side and Gregor Bognor mods on the fly screen. It was just like, let's go downtown. I was like, well, I'm not going downtown.
And that got
I was like, no way, no way, somebody might see me.
I think it's the highlight of the weekend, all these thousands of scooters, all the blue flume of the smoke comes up of them, and it's great to see. And it created chaos on the road for about an hour.
Going on the ride out?
No.
Why not?
Should go home. No. I've had enough. We've had enough. We've had as much fun as we can get out of this rally now and we're going to go home.
And plus we're boring bastards, really. We don't do ride outs. Need to be in a group of thousands to look good.
I think when you do get old, because I'm saying I'm now officially an old age pensioner, or senior citizen, whatever you call it, so mixing with people a lot younger than yourselves, it does give you a young outlook on life. So I highly recommend it. If when you get on a little bit years, try and mix a lot of young people, so it gives you a good incentive to keep going. I reckon the scooter scene, because I'm saying there's lots and lots of young people in it, and I think that really keeps me young at heart. But what is a good thing on the scooter scene is you get lots of families come along there with their children. And I think that it keeps everyone young, and the children are sort of an influence on everything sort of ticking over nicely. Wasn't feeling 100% in my health, and I went to the old doctor, and through various tests they sent me to the hospital, and they suddenly discovered I had a tumour, and I was told that on Friday the 13th 1995, and I was in hospital in about 10 days, and they operated and obviously removed the tumour, but I think it was about 18 months before I thought I'm ready. So I dug the old scooter out, sort of give it a kicked it over and sort of re-oiled it and all that sort of thing. And I thought, I'm going, you know, and so I started driving again. You know, since then, I think it would have been about 90, through 96, through end of 96, I started riding again, and it felt good. Touch wood, my health's been quite good over the last sort of 2 years. And long may it continue so I can keep scootering for many years to come.
I mean, if the world could be more open and get into scooters, they don't know what they're missing. Forget the rave scene, forget the dance scene. Get into the scooter scene. It's something else. It will change your life completely. It's fantastic.
On the last night on the Isle of Wight, to my utter delight, and amazement, I was presented with a trophy for Scooters of the Decade. And, you know, I'm highly delighted with that. You know, it's something that I don't think anyone's ever had a trophy like this before. And to me, that was magic.
Our interest in scooters is a hobby. It's far beyond that. It's borderline obsession. It's 17 years of eating, drinking, sleeping, building riding scooters.
It's a sad old cliche, but
it is a way of life.
Way of life.
Weekend FT, and you thought it only covered business.
Dion.
Now, one of the sassiest performers we've had here on Preview has to be Edwin Starr. Not only is he playing a few dates in the region, but he also lives here. So, what better excuse for us to send Rachel out to make eye-to-eye contact with him at home?
Edwin's been a king of Motown since the mid-50s, and as Rachel found out, he's got no intention of stopping.
Hello, Edwin.
How are you?
I'm fine. Can I come in?
Yes, come on in.
Let the dogs out.
Yes, the guys out.
Edwin, here we are in your beautiful house.
Thank you.
Right in the middle of the Midlands.
Yes.
Now, it's very different from where you actually came from, because you were from Nashville, Tennessee, weren't
That's
you?
Right. That's
and you lived
right.
in Detroit, and I'm sure you've lived everywhere else ever since.
Well, just about Ohio, and then from Ohio to Detroit, Detroit, California, and California to here.
But why did you actually choose this spot? Because you are in the middle of nowhere, really.
My guys in my band are from this immediate area. Mm. And I was staying in London, and I was paying exorbitant rents, and they said, come down to the Midlands and look around. Maybe you'll find something that you like. And this is what I found.
What is it like, though, when you leave this area and you go off on tour? That must be very, very difficult.
Well, that portion of it is always demanding because the work is very, very demanding. We have been extremely busy for the last 8 to 10 years. So, and it just gets better and better.
Well, never one to rest on his laurels, Edwin's busy rehearsing for his Dancing in the Street tour, where he's joining forces with Martha Reeves and Mary Wilson.
Do you still get nervous? Because you were saying you're doing new things every night.
Most definitely. Because of it always being a new audience, okay? And you never know, you know, what the night is going to hold for you. So if you go out there with the intentions of wowing the audience, and you quite often fall on your face. But if you go out there just with the intentions of doing the best that you can possibly do, it normally works out well.
And he's more than modest about his fans.
I get a quite a deal of adulation from people, but it's more polite than it is hysteric.
And when you're not working,
yeah,
what do you do? Because I've seen you've got two dogs, you've got an electric bike, and you love classic cars.
Yes.
So
that's
tell
it.
Me.
You got it all in one.
Yeah.
I like tootling around with my cars. I like that, and I'm waiting for the weather to break so I can get on my electric bike and you know, try that out.
For how long? 26 miles.
26 miles.
Out.
Yeah.
Sign off, I want you to teach me a Motown move. Come on, there must be one Motown move you can teach me.
Okay, the only one that everybody wants to know is the Temptation Walk.
Go on then.
Come on. Show you. Now you gotta
right,
do
go on.
It's like.
Okay.
Okay.
How am I doing?
You're doing good. Fine. Temptation Walk.
Edwin will be starring at venues across the region. As for Rachel, this week, she just can't stop dancing.
different makes of scooters in the shops, and deciding whether you want to commute, look cool, or ride for fun isn't always easy.
So, we've asked Marie Creswell, who runs a mobile hairdressing business in Derby on her 50cc Trekker, to help us road test a few. Are you ready, Marie?
Ready.
We're on our way to one of Marie's customers. Marie's 50cc Peugeot cost her £1,670. Top speed's only 50, but who cares when you get 100 to the gallon and the road tax is only £15. It's her company scooter.
My husband and I were driving by one Sunday afternoon. We saw them all parked outside Smalley Cross. And he just happened to say, you ought to get one of those for work.
Hi. I brought my friend Susie with me today. Is that okay?
Yeah.
I'm absolutely knocked out by the pile of kit Marie carries in her rucksack and top box.
Beautiful.
Back to town for a coffee. Me on the Korean-made 125cc Hyosung Grand Prix. That'll set you back £2,140.
Quite sluggish, wasn't it, really, for its size?
Extremely, yeah. Very bulky. I found it very hard to handle. Yeah. It was extremely heavy. I couldn't get it off the stand.
I couldn't get it on the stand.
Couldn't get it back on the stand.
Now, if I was to have a scooter full-time, it would have to be large enough to accommodate my shopping.
So, to the supermarket on the zany Italjet Dragster, a 125cc scoot which will set you back £2,420. And guess what? We both want one.
It just felt so comfortable. I felt in control. It just really handled well on the road. I had the power. It looked good.
When you were on it, it was almost like a part of it. It just felt quite sexy, really, as you're sort of going around the country lanes. I'll never fit that in.
Oh, one each, Susie, they look nice. Hope we're going to be able to get this in, Susie.
All right, let's try it.
Oh, no, can't we even get one in a lot?
Not a shopper's bike, that one. Okay, let's try it in the Grand Prix. There you go, Susie.
There we go.
Well, it may not be the quickest of them all, but it looks like it's shopper's paradise bike. Look, perfect.
So, the Hyosung Grand Prix wins the shopping stakes, and with the new model out later this year, it should give the big scoots a run for their money.
But the thing I want to know is, can we still go out tonight and look $1 million when we've been on our scooters all day? Look out, Derby.
Here we come.
The great thing about scooting is beating the traffic. The downside? Well, on a night when the temperature drops to freezing, you may wish you were languishing in a nice warm car.
That way.
Now, this is what you call a real makeover. And we've bought all the essential tools on our scoots, including our gorgeous crumple-free outfits.
Wow.
No one would ever guess we're out on the town on two wheels.
Cheers. It's been a good day.
For more information on the features in tonight's show...